Now it is my great pleasure to introduce my colleague and my director and my very good friend, Beth Jacoby, who is the artistic director and the director and one of our primary choreographers for Dance Visions New York. I'm talking about Beth Jacoby, and I couldn't be happier to be introducing anybody else.
Thank you. No,
it's just this day has really been perfect, and I think you're the icing on the cake. So
you're
I'm
so
really
sweet.
Very glad that you're here.
Thank you.
I do want to say one thing. I didn't realize, you know, we've been working together for a very long time, mm-hmm. and Dance Visions, and it's now the form that it's in now, began in 1990.
Yeah.
We've been working together for over 20 years. We're practically engaged. I think it's wonderful. Anyway, let me just begin by saying that your company, I think, is wonderful, and that you do contemporary works, very cutting edge contemporary works, and the repertoire of the great mother of modern dance, Isadora Duncan.
Right.
That your company is the authentic performers of the repertoire.
Mm-hmm.
So that's really, I think that's something very special. And that you have been performing here on the island, that you are the recipient of the New York State Council for the Arts grants each year to present your programs.
Mm-hmm.
And it has really been my pleasure and my honor to be involved. I very often am the, I am the host and the narrator, and once I was even one of the dancers.
Yes, you were.
So
that's wonderful.
We really go a long way back.
Uh-huh.
But let me just begin at the beginning. You danced with many companies, and I should mention that you're a teacher, that you
mm-hmm.
have your own school.
Mm-hmm.
That you teach adults and you teach children. You
right.
have children dancing.
Right.
A wonderful company.
Thank you.
And I think at this time, for the programs that we're doing, your young dancers are really wonderful.
Mm-hmm. They've come along.
But how did this all begin? Take us, start at the beginning.
When I first came to Great Neck, back in 88, right? And then I definitely wanted to start a school and chose a house with a basement that could be used as a dance studio,
uh-huh.
and proceeded to do that the following year in 1989, and that's where my school started, and definitely always had the choreographic urge. I loved dancing, I loved being an interpreter of movement and other people's works, certainly, of course, the Duncan works as well, but also definitely had the creative urge to create my own. And that has been going since, of course you do it with students, it's at the school, but been doing it professionally since 1990. When we first started, we were very much a collaborative company and we all were doing works for each other, which was very exciting and brought in all sorts of new ideas. It's been a long time that I've been creating works.
Yeah.
And it evolves with the human being. The content, the themes
yeah.
evolve with how you, as you're growing.
Yeah.
I just want to mention that in terms of my own teaching, of course I have my school children dancing, but I also now teach at the adults at Great Neck Adult Education.
Yes, yes,
so
and you have been a teaching artist
as well
for the Tillis Center,
and Tillis
which
Center,
I think is very impressive.
Which I'll go back to actually
yeah.
next year.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
So it's a lot of different age groups and
yeah.
different coming from different places
yeah.
in terms of teaching. Yeah.
Yeah. yeah. I kind of would like to just talk about, let's just touch on your contemporary works
uh-huh.
because I think we're going to
uh-huh.
see them first. What is it that gets your creative juices going? I mean, what
okay.
is it an idea?
Yeah.
Is it something seen, heard,
yeah.
imagined?
Every time it's different.
Yeah, music?
Yeah, every time it's different. Certainly music has often been the catalyst. I think more recently it's themes, kind of the newest scientific themes, believe it or not,
yeah.
about the universe and about theories of physics and the concept of multiple universes and things
I'm
on
always,
different levels.
I'm always surprised when you do that because, I really am. Maybe it's because I'm just not tuned into science, but I guess there is a relationship. And I'm always, you know, very impressed.
Well, the science also ties into philosophy, you know, and almost spirituality. Yeah. So I find them very, very tied together, and the concept of universality and individuality. And, you know, in a way, the piece that I'm you're going to see first has a lot to do with that, how we're all connected and we're also individual, and pulls apart and pulls together. Yeah. You'll be seeing that. It's got
however,
a lot of level.
The contemporary piece that we're going to see was very much influenced by art.
As well, yes, as well, visual art, yes, yes. It's, well, parts you'll see was a performance without the visual art in the background, just because the video is very clear. The end of that, you'll see a little bit of the end of that piece with some of the projections of the artwork of Susan Ruth Cohn, which is beautiful and very abstract, and we felt like the themes that we were both thinking of really connected, and so actually this comes out of Color Song, which was an original book of hers, and then we both sort of delved deeper into it, and she created new artwork, and I created a new choreography that went deeper into this theme that we both were very connected to, I think.
But the painting was sort of the initial thing.
Initially,
that got
I
you
saw
going.
Her book, and I saw her paintings, and that started the whole thing, exactly.
So it can be a variety of things, really, that inspire
even visual
you.
Art, right.
Yeah. Okay, so that's kind of the contemporary piece we're going to see. But you are, I mean, your company and you are really the interpreter of the authentic works of Isadora Duncan. So take us back to your beginnings with that.
I mean, I've been a dancer my whole life. I started out with the Isadora Duncan techniques taught by Julia Levine, who was the major propagator of the technique the generation before me. She passed it on to a handful of people, you know, but it's been part of my heritage since I was 5 years old. And then later on, I went into ballet, and I went into modern dance, I should say. At the time, it was more modern dance. Now it's contemporary. I went into jazz, in fact. But always, the Duncan thing was in my life. And there was a company that formed back in 1977. I didn't join at first. I was still very young and still really into other dance forms. But I did eventually go back to it, and it's just, as I say, it's sort of my heritage dance, and it's beautiful, and the more involved I got with it, the more understanding of all the levels, you know, of this type of dance. And people are coming back to it now. You know, it's very based on the you know, potency and the beauty of nature and natural and movement, which comes from that source, as well as classical Greek mythology.
Well, the classical
art.
Greek repertoire, we're going to see a lot of that.
Yeah.
It's really interesting, because I know that in your company, which is really excellent now, the company that you have.
Yeah, the dancers are fabulous.
Dancers who've never done Duncan before, I'm very interested in observing their reaction to the work. And they really take to it.
Yeah.
And they really love it, because there's just something that gets to your soul
about
that work.
Exactly.
You know, I mean, she went to her soul, and I think it's so strong and so potent that the dancers get it, and the audience really gets it.
And it has to be, like, really heartfelt.
Yeah.
And even I'm teaching that, and my adult students are getting it. Everybody's feeling, you know, their potential through this movement.
I think we're tempting our audience, because we're talking about the work, and now we're going to get a chance to see it.
Okay.
So the first thing we're going to see, I think, is through the portals.
It's from it, excerpts from the piece, not the beginning.
Excerpts from Through the Portals.
I believe so.
Thank you. where such passion is that stretcheth me apart, I fear you made the world too beautiful this year. My soul is all but out of me. Chase, the hunted draws near. The moon, as it rises, gives flight to the deer.